look at all you lovely people over here doing your thing, saying, I'm first, I'm first. Welcome in and happy Thursday, everybody. Hope you're having a wonderful day. I'm very upset. Mike Duck has just ejected from the microphone. So hold on, I have to rest. All right, Mike Duck is safe. We're good. It will go back to its place of honor right there. I need to, like, glue it up there so I don't bump it off. It doesn't actually happen very often, surprisingly enough, for as clumsy as I am. It stays up there pretty well. That and Tiny Duck. Okay? Julie, get it. So cute. If you guys haven't heard the story of this, I'll let you know on the Discord, the story of Tiny Duck. Tiny Duck is this transcontinental duck. I got it in New York and it flew home in my luggage. It lived in a coffee cup for the duration of the trip, so it was safe. But anyway, congratulations to Tobinator on first and unofficial first. Burrito, good morning to you. Idiot God, hello and welcome in. Glad to see you again in the chat. Yes, you do need to watch the Victor adoption video. I was very excited that happened because, oh my God, it was like so unintentional. It was just like, foxes, we have to stop right now. And luckily, past me set up future me for success. And I had the name tags already labeled and in my ender chest, so I was able to just grab them real quick and some leads and get those little foxes home. So yay, we have a working berry farm now. It only took like 2,000 days. It's fine. But good morning, Summer and Star. Welcome into both of you. I hope you guys are having a lovely Thursday. Glad to have everybody here in the chat. It's been a hot minute. I've been busy with a lot. So how's everyone been? That's a great question. How has everybody been? I know we just saw each other Tuesday a couple days ago, but I hope you guys are all doing well. It's been a busy-ish couple of days. The washing machine is finally repaired. Yay! The repairman is not my favorite person because my appointment was from 3 to 5 p.m. and he just casually showed up at 5:45. I'm like, dude, seriously? If I did that at the doctor's office, they wouldn't see me. What's up with that? I feel like I may be getting a cold or getting sick, otherwise okay. Well, my friend, I hope you're not getting too sick. Hopefully it's just like maybe a little minor cold, some hydration, some rest, a little Jewish penicillin. You'll be right as rain. But definitely all the self-care and lots of rest so you can fight off whatever it is. We need all the folks here in the community happy, healthy, and well. So yeah, so washing machine is fixed. Hooray. Although I'm not gonna lie. The laundromat that I found is like a brand new one and it's all like chrome and pretty and everything. It's very clean, very open and airy because they have like the whole front of the place is all windows. And I can be in and out of there and do like 10 loads of laundry in 30 minutes. It's amazing. The only thing that sucks is when I get home, I then have to spend like an hour hanging up all the clothes that have to be hung up to dry. And then I have to like run cycles of stuff through the dryer. And my dryer hasn't been working right. I think the sensor's going bad on it because it's like, it's only kind of drying stuff. We've cleaned out all the excess lint. Like that was our first go-to was maybe the lint's just neat, like the lint trap or like behind is all clogged up. No, it's all clear. I think it's just the sensor on it is bad. Nothing is made to last anymore. It's very annoying. Just had 3 wisdom teeth pulled. Oh my gosh. Well, I had all 4 of mine done at the same time so I can absolutely empathize with how that feels. And my suggestion to you is warm salt water, swish and rinse. Eat very soft foods for probably the first 3 to 4 days. And just keep your mouth really, really, really clean. Like brush your teeth as often as you can after every meal. Very important, it helps it heal up quicker and less likelihood of getting infections. And also watch out for dry socket. If they didn't tell you about that, look it up. And Zeezy, welcome in. Glad to see you, my friend. Hope you're doing well, and thank you. The hair kind of cooperated today. I have a weird little cowlick going on right back here, but it's luckily kind of out of shot, so it's all right. I'm still continuing the journey of growing it out, and it's a process. It's at this point where it's too long to be short and too short to be long, and so doing things with it is a... Someone has the zoomies. And he's back. Oh, hello. Hello, are you gonna come over here and say hi to the people? Come here. Come here. Oh, he has a treat. That's why. Yes. Puppy has his greenie. He went out for a walk and he gets a greenie afterwards. So he's very excited. Anyway, yeah. So the hair is getting to that point. Once I get it to like where it's all the way past my chin, I can start like doing cute stuff with the flat iron and like putting little beachy waves and stuff. But for the time being, I'm kind of stuck with it. Just this. It is what it is. And Kelly, welcome in. KT, welcome in. Glad to see you guys. Hope you're doing all right. Glad to have you here. Last one was still too far up for them to take today, so it may be taken later. Yeah, that makes that does happen, where if it's still too impacted and they have to either wait for it to grow out, or they might have to go in and like cut it out later. But that's always nice, because then you get to go to sleep for that process. That's always good. Looks like my cousin's dog. Yeah, so he's, I don't know where he went. He was here and then he's gone. He's some sort of terrier blend mutt type of dog. We don't know exactly what he is, but he has all the energy and the muscle tone of a Jack Russell Terrier. Even though he's almost 14 years old, he still gets the zoomies on fairly regular occasion. So he's a good boy. He's an old grumpy man, but he's a very good boy, and I love him to death. And Baka, welcome in. Glad to see you. Hope you're doing well. Ryan, you as well. Welcome in. I'm gonna leave stream before I leave for the UK today. You're gonna stream before you leave for the UK. Oh, gotcha. Sorry. I read that wrong. But that's very cool. That's right. Your trip's coming up. I can't wait to hear all about it when you get back. Sorry, we're doing much talking. Got the dry mouth. Alrighty, so that's life. Yesterday, I got to hang out with a friend and had a lovely day. Got to go to Trader Joe's, which y'all know I love that. Bought a whole bunch of stuff to restock my freezer. And had a good lunch, good visit. I'm in good mental health, good spirits. You can't go wrong with that. And with that, it's time to go to hell. Because that's where we are in the game right now. When we left off, we were looting the Nether Fortress. So we are jumping right in. We are doing that today. I've got the kick-ass music on today. I was just in that kind of mood. You gotta get ready to pack today. Oh, RIP to that, my friend. Packing for me is probably one of the more stressful parts of my travel experience. Because I'm one of those people who packs the entire house and the kitchen sink because of the, what about if this happens? And I have to make sure that I plan for every possible contingency. So yeah, needless to say, I always have to trap. But, and my husband will attest to this, never have we not had what we needed if something went sideways. So it's all good. I was there in the chair. Last thing I remember, the doctor came in and sucked me to the IV, and then I was out. Nice. Yeah, the conscious sedation is a jam. When I had my neck procedures late last year and the beginning of this year, I got the temporary knockout juice. That was wild, man. Like, I was just there laying on the table because I had to be face down because they're doing it on the back of my neck. So I have like one of those little donut rings, and I'm just laying face down the table. The nurse anesthetist was just chit-chatting with me and hanging out, and just all of a sudden they're like, okay, you're done. And I'm like, what? It was like that. It was incredible. Definitely down for that. If you could stream it on a computer to watch with people. Okay, so Star and Ryan, what are you guys chit-chatting about? What's on Prime? I need to follow up here. I hate needles so much, so I started to get anxious, and then bam, I was out. That's the way to do it right there. Just take that anxiety and just drug it up. All right, so we've got lots of mobs right here around us. Just over this way, we've got blazes. That way, like right above us, we've got a wither skeleton. So we got to be mindful of that. This way, I believe. Yeah, this way is our way out. Yeah, that was the way out. Okay. And then this way is our way into the fortress. So let's get all this going. Real quick, I need to make some more torches because I do not have enough torches for what we're doing, because I do likes to do the torches. Okay. They finally revealed an actual release date for Has-Been Hotel today after years of waiting. Oh, nice. That's cool. I want to say Kid One watches that. I might be wrong. I might be thinking it's this. Maybe I'm thinking of something else. I don't know. Too many torches. That's okay. Too many is better than not enough. We likes the torches. Okay. Let's drop off the last little bit of extra things here. We're going to keep the signs in case we need to label anything. Prime 2024. Nice. All right. So we're headed up. We hear blazes. We have to be mindful of that. We should be. There's okay. That guy just scared the crap out of me, but it's all right. We should be okay here. Okay, please don't get in the way. It would be very bad if you got in the way. Is there a blaze down the hallway? Can they? Okay, hold on. Real quick. Can nether mobs spawn in light levels? Like, do light levels matter for nether spawns? Because if so, I might want to, like, slab over the floors just so that way they're done. I don't know. We'll see. Apparently, they aren't even making season two as well, so hopefully that means consistency. Oh, that's always nice. That is always a nice thing. All right, so we're going to go this way. We're just going to head back up to the area where we were. Okay, so go back this way, more hallways beyond the Netherwart farm. Okay. Then there's also this direction we need to go. This is all nothing here. Hold on, I wanna block this up. I don't know why, I don't like holes when I'm walking along in these hallways. It makes me worry that I'm gonna fall through. Okay, so that is outside. So then there's nothing over here. This is just a patio. Let's head back over by the farm. So you're hungry right now. Well, if you're still numb from the wisdom teeth extraction, I recommend have something soft that you can just kind of mush with your tongue in the roof of your mouth. Because if you are still really numb, there's a good potential you could bite your tongue, and that's not good. Season 1 is released in January 2024 on Prime for stream. Nice. And doesn't have an exact date in January, but it seems like it will be for sure then. Well, that's good. So January 2024, then you know that at least for sure. And thank you, Ryan. We are in hell. Gotta hydrate more often. Excited for more Luna videos. All right, so this is a scary outside hallway. All right, I just got stuck on that fence right there. That's a bad thing. Let's get rid of that fence. I do not need to get hung up on that later. That would be really bad. Jello, yeah, Jello would be lovely. That's a great thing to have, because then you don't have to worry about potentially. I don't like this because something might drop right on my head. Let's do the thing here. Jello's good because you don't have to like chew it. You just mush it with your mouth, and you can get the stuff. Plus, Jello has protein because there's the gelatin in it, which is usually like a animal-based collagen type thing. So that's good. You're in a hot place to drink. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's hell. It's hot. We got to drink for sure. Okay. Okay. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just doing a little bit of not spawn proofing necessarily, but spawn protection. So I don't get mobs dropping on my head in this like cavernous area here. Okay. So now nothing can just drop on my head. If it drops down on me, it will fall right off the edge, which haha, not my problem. I love Luna and Bee and Mox and Millie. I don't know what any of those characters are, but I'm glad they bring you joy. I use Jello when my throat hurts, which might be good today, actually, though I drink it when it's still hot. You know, I've heard of that. I remember that kind of being like a home remedy kind of situation back when I was a kid. I want to say my grandmother used to do that. All right, so we're going to do that. My gut's telling me to go this way. Like, there's a whole lot here, so we gotta protect here. We also need to protect ceiling because I don't want things like dropping down from above. I can already see that pig man there, and that would make me very nervous that it would just suddenly drop on my head. So you gotta go away. What do we got here? Toxic Killer Cheese Man has arrived. Welcome in. Glad to have you here in the chat. Hope you're having a wonderful Thursday. And Horse, welcome in. It sounds like Horse is trying to tie a tie, and it's not going well. Yeah, that is a bit of a frustration situation. when I have in the past been helping someone tie a tie and I have trouble, it usually helps if you just completely undo it, start over after you take a couple deep breaths. And yes, the YouTube tutorials are always helpful. Even if you've done it before and you're having trouble, the tutorial is nice to just break it down step by step. But Horace, glad to see you. Hope you're having a good morning so far. And Toxic, glad to have you here in the chat. You got on my recommended list. Hey, cool. Well, that's exciting. And I'm really glad that you're here, Toxic. You're very welcome. And feel free to make yourself at home here in the chat. Just a reminder, unlike Star Stream, this is a family-friendly chat. So do be courteous to those in the chat who prefer a little less spicy content. We do have mature audiences only stream periodically. But I always denote when it's one of those just so people know, okay, we can take the filters off. Ambroski, good morning to you. Hope you're having a wonderful Thursday. Glad to have you in the chat as well. Ties aren't hard, but videos help for beginners. That's what I use. Yeah, exactly. Same. Anytime I've had to tie a tie for someone, having that tutorial just there ready to go is always a huge help. And like I said, if you get to that point where you're just stressing about it, it's time to just like take a breath and come back to it. All right, staircases I hate because you never know when something's gonna drop on your head. Don't like it. Okay, there's that. We're good there. Okay, so this way, oh, okay, I know where I am now. This hallway, we're gonna do the same thing here. We're gonna cover it up so that way nothing like comes out at me here. More blocks, please. Thank you. Of course, I like being family friendly more than not. Well, there you go. Hey, Star, ended up being home early because of me. How's life, Mom? Life is going well. I was saying that I got to hang out with and have lunch with a friend yesterday, which is always a blast. And I got to go to Trader Joe's, something I always really enjoy. I don't know why. Just Trader Joe's going there makes me happy. I don't know what it is, but it does. Okay, so we got torch here. That's got torch there. Okay, so this is the hallway. If I remember correctly, this is the one where I had it cut through, right? E. Yeah, I think this is where we had it cut through to the other side. Let me see. Yes. Okay. This is where I said go through this way. This is a thing. I don't know what's over here. That is down, and we do not want down. Down is bad. Let's just pop a torch right there. We will do this and then bust through here just so I can see that that's a down. More of a thing for future me. Like, hey, that's a thing, so just be careful. I don't know what Trader Joe's is. Okay. Trader Joe's, for the uninitiated and the unknowing. Trader Joe's is a grocery store chain here in the U.S. I think they have them in other countries, but I'm not positive. For sure in the U.S. Their whole kind of, I don't know what the word is, but basically their whole platform, I guess we'll just call it, is they partner with companies, like major companies like Heinz and like just name brands. And they buy product from them at a very cheap price, relabel it as Trader Joe's label, and then they sell it at a lower price than what original name brand was. So you don't have so much the name brand recognition, but you're still getting those name brand products. They're just all Trader Joe's. The difference is with Trader Joe's products, anything with the Trader Joe's product, their whole thing is that there's no artificial colors, preservatives, flavorings, all that. So they tend to be slightly healthier food. Like you're not gonna get the junky trick cereal and stuff like that. You'll get more natural and or organic type foods, which is right up my alley because I'm a little bit hippie crunchy like that. But they also have a lot of like fresh prepared type things like salad bowls and sushi and things like that. So like if you're on your lunch break and you're like, oh my God, I gotta go get some lunch, you can pop into Trader Joe's and like, boom, there's some food already ready to go. And it's fairly healthy, which is nice. They have a good amount of like fresh produce and in my case, a nice assortment of like gluten-free type things. Like I get my bagels there because they're way cheaper than name brand, but they're literally the same thing as the name brand ones. But yeah, I love me some Trader Joe's. That, and it's just, they always are very like a very small type of store. They're not like the big giant grocery store like when you go into a Safeway or Vons or a Walmart grocery store. Like they're a little small. They usually go into like one of those strip mall pads. And I love that. I love that they're little tiny little stores. It gives you that mom and pop feel, which is great. Oh, and you're from the EU. Yeah, that's why. Let's see. Let me pop back here. Trader Joe's is amazing. Yes, I agree. Best popsicles in the world. Even though I've never had their popsicles. I should try that. If they're gluten-free, of course. Also found out I can graduate early by taking one class over the summer. Oh my God, that's amazing. I'm so excited for you. Well, hopefully you're able to get into that class and you can get that knocked out so you can graduate early. That would be awesome. Yes. And we got Kelly and KT saying hello. Back with cherry jello. Nice. Good choice. Cherry jello is best. And Kelly, thank you for letting us know you're lurking. No worries. I'll make sure I don't call you out if you're working. That way you can kind of stay focused. Never actually been inside a Trader Joe's. Oh, people, if you have a Trader Joe's in your area, just go in. You can't go wrong. They have snacks. They have coffee, like free stuff. They have pretty flowers you can buy for super cheap. And then, yeah, tons of good stuff. If you have kids, look out. So Toxic, I want to say, well, not even like Aldi and stuff. That's different. Those are more like, that's more like grocery outlet. Anyway. Yeah, I'm trying to, I don't know of any other, like, yeah, coffee. Yeah, they have coffee samples there at Trader Joe's. They give you, like, the little tiny sample cups, and you get your little coffee and your little bite of pastry, and, like, it just makes you happy while you shop. You can't go wrong. Taking my time eating so I don't bite my tongue. Yes. Slow and steady. Like I said, use your tongue and, like, just smush it to the roof of your mouth. No actual teeth involved. It's the safest way. Okay, so you have like something similar. It's just not exactly the same. Okay, so this hallway we've cleared. So we're gonna do the little clearing thing here. So that way I know, don't go that way. This is another T hallway here. Shall return in a bit? Need to let out the goobs. Okay, yes, let out the Ollie man and, sorry, somehow I typed in my chat over here. And we'll see you when we see him. Okay, I don't like when we have these T's like this and it's not protected. So same thing, we're gonna do this. That goes to the outdoors. Outdoors are scary. No outdoors. Outdoors bad. Okay, so that we have lava directly above us, so that's definitely something to take care of. Oh my goodness, KT. Wow. Sounds way different, but it's kind of also cheaper. Oh, okay, gotcha. And KT with the 5 gifted subs, holy cow. Welcome into Mushroom Beady, Razor Wolf, It's Me Baka, Summer Fades to Winter, and Bucko Man to the Holy Order of the Lava Watchers. Please feel free to hit exclamation mark Discord and let us know in the either stream chat or just general channel that you were gifted a sub, and we'll make sure we get you that Lava Watchers role. Great thing about our community is once you have a subscriber role on our Discord, you have it forever. Because as far as I'm concerned, once you're family, you're always family. And I don't take that away just because you don't sub, because I don't feel like this is a financially driven community. And while I appreciate subs and I appreciate bits and all that good, lovely, generous stuff, it's never expected and not needed. So anything like that is nice. I can roll it back into community type stuff. But thank you as always, KT, for looking out for the community and making sure people are set up. That is super awesome. What is that? Horse Taco noticed me. Horse, if you're still listening, Ryan wants your attention. So if you could please, you have his number. All right. Seriously, man. Hell is dehydrating. Oh, idiot god. Good timing. Yes, because I'm getting a little bit anxious being in the Nether. This would be a great time for Moment of Zen. So let me real quick. We're going to go to the music here. We're going to find some yoga music. I always use yoga music for my Moment of Zen because it's just so pretty. So let's see if we can find one. No, that's not yoga music. We need yoga. We need calm and peaceful yoga music. All right, so there we go. We've got our Moment of Zen. Silly, I love being silly, yes. We are all a little silly here. All right, so we're just gonna take this moment because I'm feeling a little antsy being in the Nether and because everyone's just hyped up today. Our Moment of Zen today is just gonna be a calming moment of peaceful meditation. So I encourage everybody to just close your eyes and just focus inward for a minute. All together, we're going to take a nice, deep, cleansing breath. And exhale. Inhale again. And exhale. Sorry, horse. In this moment, as you continue with those deep cleansing breaths, just let your focus turn completely inward. Find that heart center and find what brings you joy. Whatever makes you feel happiest right here in this moment, focus on that. Imagine it like a little glowing orb in your hands. That is your happiness. And it's like a warm little ball in your hand and it's just swirling and it's like a purplish white, kind of a hazy ball. And it's just joy. And you can feel the warmth and you can feel the happiness emanating from it. You're gonna take that and you're just gonna press it to your heart center. You're just gonna feel it go right into your core and fill you up with that purplish white energy. Happy and peaceful and calm. And you're gonna carry that with you all day long. No matter what, no matter what stresses you, no matter what makes you anxious or nervous or unhappy, think of that peaceful, calming, purplish white light. Let's take one more deep breath together. And exhale.
And that, my friends, is your moment of Zen. Namaste.
All right. So I hope you all enjoyed that. Horse, you can come back now. Horse hates moment of Zen. It drives him nuts. All right. Let me go ahead and get back to our rock and roll music. I gotta turn this back down so I don't blow people's eardrums out. I pushed a button. Oh no, what happened? It's fine. I fix it. We're good. Give me 1 second, guys. I just gotta fix the audio here and make sure it's at the right levels. Unfortunately, it does not auto-correct depending on the genre. I have to go in and like tidy it all up. So we're good. And Razor, welcome in. I hope you're having a wonderful morning. Yes, someone had redeemed our moment of Zen, Channel Point Redemption. And so that was our moment of Zen. Yeah, no Zen, I know. Yeah, Horace can come back and bring the chaos since Levi's not here with us today. Alrighty, but I do appreciate that. That was actually exactly what I needed because it gave me the opportunity to just not be super stressed. All right, so we're gonna come through here. All of what we're doing here is we're just making these hallways safer, lighting things up, just like so. Torch, torch. We're gonna block here because I don't want any wither skeletons dropping down on me. It's terrible. It is over, Horse. You're safe. Feel free to come back. Okay, same thing here. Lots of plugging up of holes because wither skeletons can come right through the ceiling there and drop down on top because they can spawn up on top of those blocks. Any nether brick they can spawn on, and I do not want them falling on my head. That has happened, and I scream, and nobody wants that. Oh, and Broski, Regina, hydrate. Thank you very much. I missed that. I had my eyes closed, so thank you. Got the tie tied. We are good to go. She mentioned, but others can trigger it, would be chaotic for you. Yeah, no, Horse just doesn't like Moment of Zen. He doesn't like the tone of my voice. He says it's weird, and he doesn't like it. Yes, I did get the hydrate. Hydrate is good. Somehow my cup just splashed me in the head. That was weird. It's not pretty, but it will do. As long as it looks intentional and it isn't sloppy, you should be fine. All right, so no wither skeleton there. No wither skeleton in here. That way they can't spawn there. Oh, I'm almost out of netherrack. Okay. I kind of want to run back and go get more netherrack, but that probably wouldn't be the best idea. Oh, okay. Give me 1 sec, guys. Sorry, I have a kid thing to attend to. Okay, I have returned. I miss not wearing a tie. I do not miss wearing a tie for work. Yeah, I have like a closet full of business clothes that I bought from my job, and I kind of am sad that I didn't get more opportunity to wear them, but at the same time, I kind of like being able to hang out in my yoga pants. Not gonna lie, it's not too bad. All right, okay, which way, which way, which way? This way. We're gonna go down this long, scary hallway here. We're gonna do this, and we're gonna block this off right here, so no wither skelly can come this way. I'm gonna do this. Well, that's not good, because I'm almost out of blocks. Oh, don't look at that Enderman, that would be bad. No Endy Man, thank you. All right, so that way's fine, this way's done. So we have that hallway, and we have that hallway. Lots of stuff there. I'm hopefully at just the beginning of wearing a tie. Yes, fingers crossed, we hope that. Don't miss wearing any of it, still have it all, but it made some of it last almost 10 years. Okay, so that's the thing with business attire, especially for men. It tends to be very classic in the look, and so it can last trend-wise a long time. But also, like, men's suits last freaking forever. My husband has had the same 2 suits for 15 years, and they still look brand new. I don't know how this is possible, but it does. Excuse me, men's business attire doesn't change. Dress shirt and dress pants. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, men's stuff looks pretty, like, classic. There's ways that, like, the trend-wise they change. So, for example, when I was in New York, I saw tons of guys dressed up. Obviously, I was in, like, a business district, so there's tons of people in suits. So you had more of, like, the trendy colors. Like, I saw one guy wearing, like a paler blue suit. It wasn't, like, navy. It was, like, a lighter blue. But a lot of them were wearing like 3-piece suits. So they had like the vest and the jacket and the pants, but they're all cut very slim fit nowadays. Like lots of the guys are wearing very slim fit clothes. So that's a trend. But like a guy could show up to a job interview right now just wearing a classic suit and be fine. Like no one would bat an eye. If a woman showed up wearing an 80s dress with shoulder pads and high heels, she would look weird. I don't like that. It's a double standard. Found a really good brand through the fire department called 511. Oh, Razor, we love us some 511 in this house. Yes, 511 is great. Great tactical stuff. Polos and button downs and pants could go from office to into turnout gear. Yep, exactly. Yeah, the cargo pants are the bee's knees. Tovenator uses those for range days. He wears the cargo pants. Not always 511, but that is one brand that he's used. Three-piece suits are dope, and I honestly want a very nice one very bad. Yeah, I mean, honestly, I have, it doesn't matter age, shape, status in life, no man looks bad in a three-piece suit, okay? They look good on everyone. As long as they're fitted properly, they look good on every person, okay? Just say, hey, they look good on a lot of women too. Just gonna put it out there. Yeah, shoulder pads. I'm just not trimmed enough for that, and do not stash that away. What? What? I don't know what you're talking about. Totally agree on the double standard. Yeah, I need to get more good pants. A good pair of pants is always nice to have, for sure. I have the covert casual or something. They look like slacks, but had hidden pockets for mags or other gear as well. Yep, I've seen those. They are quite handy. Suits look good on both men and women. Yeah, exactly. Like I said, the asterisk to that is that they need to be properly tailored, okay? You can buy a suit off a rack and look like you're wearing a potato sack. But if it's tailored nicely, which does not cost that much money, people, it very nice. Highly recommend. Alrighty, so we have to run back to the base here because I'm all out of netherrack and I need some of that for continuing to safety proof the house here. The fortress. We got to make sure that we are protected. So we're going to go right back over to our little chest. We have a bunch of stuff tucked away there that we can use, and we are going to do that. Hold up. What is this guy here? Where he at? Oh, he's outside. Oh, there's a hallway right over here. Oh, okay. Hold up. Not here. It's out there somewhere. There's a hallway, I think. No? Maybe he's right above me? Oh, he must be right above me. Okay. I don't know if you guys are looking on the mini map here in the corner. That's not it. Right here in the corner, you can see all the mob heads. So there's a wither skeleton like right near me. And I've seen it a couple times as I've been in this area. And I'm like, where is he? He must be outside. There must be an outdoor area that we're looking at. See, like right now I'm lined up with him perfectly. So if I stair stepped up or climbed up, he'd probably land on my head and I would scream. I'm just saying. Okay. So we've got torches. Somehow I have no netherrack in here. How do I have no netherrack in here? How did that happen? That makes no sense. Anyway, okay. So I guess what we're going to do is we're just going to mine out some random netherrack here. And some quartz, apparently. Cool. All right, I'll take that. Works for me. Three-piece would look nice, but I feel too fat anymore to get another. Well, you know, again, same thing. Get one that feels comfortable and just get it tailored. That's what matters. The tailoring is where it's at. All right, we're gonna do this. Careful, because apparently we're like right at the edge of basalt. Okay, when this happens, that always trips me out. It's like, Block, are you okay? Okay, so where is this wither skeleton? He's like right here above me. He keeps aggroing on me and he's walking around. So he's gotta be like right up above me. If I come over here, he's gonna drop down, I bet. I bet he's like hanging out. Okay, he's over here now. Are you gonna drop down? What the heck? So he's over here. Oh, he's gotta be like right above me. Uh-uh, I'm not having that fall on my head. Nope. Is it mean that I was hoping a wither chased you last time since I've never seen you do anything? Oh, you've never seen me anything but calm and collected? Oh, it will happen. Just wait, I will start freaking out. And confidence is key, yes, exactly. I can do that in my kilt, I'm just cheap too. Well, okay, that's fair on both counts. Yes, the kilt, definitely a win. Highly recommend that for everybody. Tovenator has a tacked kilt, and I love that. And blocks. Okay, we got the blocks. So where is that wither skeleton? I want him to drop down. So like, yeah, so he's aggroing on me. He's like moving around, he knows I'm here. Okay, you know what, hold up. We're gonna book it over here. Where is this guy? Oh, he's like right up there. There's a hole right there. Okay, hold on. Here's what we're gonna do. We are gonna use some of these blocks and we're gonna do a thing right here. I have to be careful because I am kind of over lava, but we're gonna do this right here. Mom doesn't freak out on stream as much as she does in person. Yeah, no, I can hide my anxiety better on stream than I can, or on stream than I can IRL. IRL, I'm much more antsy and anxious, for sure. Hey, there he is. We found him. All right, my friend, I need you to come over here. I'm going to need you to aggro onto me. Could you do that? I'm right here. How about if I make you a little path? Look, I'll make a little path right here. And you and I will talk. I'm going to go right here. Block, block. Look, come here. Come here. Come here. Yeah, come on. Right here. Are you stuck, buddy? Are you stuck? Here, let me give you a spot. Come on. Hop up. And I'm gonna boop you. No, come here. Come here. No, don't fall down. I need you to come here so I can hit you. Okay, there's one. There's two. Well, heck. That didn't work out the way I was hoping. I was really hoping that would, like, do something. But no. Oh, well. Now we go down. We get the blocks. We don't break through our path because then I fall down. And that would be bad. I don't want to test out the fire res. I do not have the confidence for a kill. Everybody can wear a kill. Absolutely. You will gain the confidence for that, I promise. It will happen. Okay, let me put... What do we got here? These extra things can go away here. We are keeping the netherrack. We're going to have to go get something for XP soon. Used to go to USA Kilt in Pennsylvania. Very nice to go get measured in store and have it made to me. My wedding outfit was a kilt and hat jacket. Oh, how nice. I love that look for weddings. I think it looks so, so nice. And, you know, again, same thing. If you don't have a thigh gap, I highly recommend deodorant. Yeah, the chafing. The chafing is not nice. Wife made you a kilt. That's very talented and very cool. And yes, they are very comfy from what I understand. Especially if you go regimental. Got a nice breeze. Got all the stuff I want laid out to pack tomorrow. Awesome. Do you have a checklist? I highly recommend checklists. It doesn't have to be on a sticky note. It just adds a little something. But checklists are nice, so that way as you put the things in your bag, you can check them off. Blondie wore a corset for her dress. Oh, bless. I have worn a corset once, and getting cinched up into that thing was... it was an experience. And I was only a teenager at the time. Because I think I mentioned this on stream before. My mom used to be in the SCA, and she did me up in one of her Renaissance gowns once. And whew. Oh my goodness, Calvin C, welcome. Thanks so much for the raid. Hope you guys are doing well today. We're just doing a little chit-chatting while we raid our Nether Fortress here. I hope you guys had a wonderful stream. Would love to hear all about it. If you haven't already, take a few minutes to do some self-care, grab a little snack, have a drink, and then maybe come back and join us as I continue to raid this Nether Fortress. But if you're just like pooped out and you need to bounce, I totally understand. Either way, glad that you guys were able to stop in. Lost my train of thought. Calvin, if you could please let us know how your stream went. We'd love to hear all about it. And everybody make yourselves at home. Thank you so much for that shout out, by the way. Go check out over there at Calvin's stream and see what they've been up to. The D&D battle was really good. Took two 4d10 swings and a big d12 strike and lived. Nice. Well done. Alrighty. Yeah, the kill has to be regimental. Exactly. Don't use a list. Don't be convinced. Uh-huh. You know what? Lists are life. You can hate on the lists all you want. I love them. It's okay. Yes. Oh, thank you. Yes, Ryan, thank you for reminding me of that. Razor, I hope you and Blondie are both feeling better. Hopefully you've rested well. Thought the raid had failed. It didn't send me. Oh no, I'm sorry. I hate when that happens. No, your people arrived, even if for some reason they left you behind. Glad to have you. Hope you're doing well. Would love to hear what you've been up to on your stream. And with that, Calvin, congratulations. You are follower 750. So thank you so much for that. Welcome into you and anybody else who is joining us today. Feel free to continue on in the chat or just lurk, listen, and watch. Whatever is your jam is totally fine. We're just kind of chilling and hanging and doing some nether raiding. It's a very casual place here. All right, well, Razor, I'm glad to hear that. And did a streamer named Fralic raid you at all? No, I don't believe so. Cheetos, yes, love them. I can actually have those because they're gluten-free. And you did some creative building. Oh, cool. What project are you guys working on? I'd love to hear about that. While you discuss, I need to reset my follower goal now because we've beat that. Yay. That's pretty cool. So we're going to bump that up to 775 because I just like those 25 numbers. I don't know why. And we're going to start that gold. Cool. Let's see. And Razor, no worries. Thank you for letting me know. Appreciate that. All right, so let's head back over here now that we took care of that wither skelly that was hanging out there. Some sort of big ancient desert with a palace and big rocks. Oh, very cool. I'll have to go check out your VOD and see how that's going. I always love custom builds like that. They are a lot of fun. Menacing, I redeemed the reward. What reward? What reward did you redeem? What reward did you redeem? Oh, I'm hearing my own voice. I don't like that. Give me one sec. I'm looking at my request queue. No, I don't see anything here. Or was it over on the other streamer's stream? You redeemed a reward over there. Hello, Gasty. Nice to hear you. We're going to go this way. It's coming along nicely. Well, good. I'm glad to hear that. All right, so we're heading to the outside here. Scary spot, scary spot. We're going to block there. We're going to block here. And we're going to block over here. That one wasn't intentional, but that's okay. We're also going to block up a top because I don't want anybody running in on me from the top. Oh my gosh, I can't place blocks today. What the heck? Could we just please get some organization? Oh, he has a reward for raiding the streamer. Gotcha. Maybe go mention that. It hasn't happened. Next time they are live. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it never hurts to just remind them. At the very least, you'll get your channel points back, I hope. Because that's always good to make sure you're taking care of your community members. Could be a time difference that they can't raid as well. Now, see, that's a very, very valid point. It could be that they just simply aren't live at the same time. That definitely happens now and then. So don't be too concerned if that's the case. Okay, so we've got a double tower. Oh, there's another tower over that way. I don't know if I've been out there yet. Okay, we're going to cover all this up here. We're going to do this. We're going to throw some torches there. Now, the reason that I put a roof on this is because blazes have a habit of floating over the top of these things and firing down, as do gas. So by giving me a roof on all these, nothing's going to jump on my head. I can see things coming. And I can make sure that, I wonder if that's a blaze spawner over there. I can make sure that nothing's going to fire on me. Wait, I'm wrong. Wrong streamer. I rewarded it for a different streamer. Well, thanks, Farido. I see how it is. Get my hopes up. No, I'm kidding. No worries. No worries at all, my friend. All right, so this is staircase. I don't know if we went down this way, but we're going to go ahead. Actually, what we're going to do is we're going to do this. Like so. So that way nothing goes in there. There's probably... Yeah, okay. Cool, that's fine. This is that external hallway thing here. We're all lit up that way. Yeah, I know that this is hard mode, so where's all the mobbies? There's a thing there. All right, let's see. Oh, here it is. Here it is. Okay. We're gonna bounce out of that. Luckily, it's enclosed, so that's good. That's something we can work with later. Scary. 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 I'm gonna run away for a minute so I can read this. Santa Fanny, I hope that's how you pronounce it. Welcome into the community. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Glad to have you, and thank you for the follow. Feel free to jump into the chat if you like, or just lurk, listen, and watch. Whatever makes you comfortable is fine by us, and we hope you're having a fantastic day. All right, so I'm down to 8 blocks, so we're going to change to cobble here because I got to make sure I have enough. I got to get some of this glowstone out of the way, though, because it is in a really bad spot, and I don't like that. I need blaze rods really bad. And so we're going to make a very basic rudimentary blaze farm here. Which basically the way that works is I block it off so I have like one little section for these blazes to come into. To where they can't get me, but I can get them. Nope, that's not it. That's the wrong spot. Break that. You need to get right there. E. Okay, and then there. Beautiful. We're going to do that. And we're going to do that. So that way they drop down and I can take care of that. Okay. I also need to do this so that we know wither skeletons can come in from the outside in case they spawn. So we're just going to do this and this. Safety spot here. And, roof. We need roof. Roof here. Actually, no, hold up. We have slabs. Let's use slabs. That would be much more appropriate. Yes, and thank you very much, KT, for the Discord link, and have you considered just cheating the blaze rods in? It works great for me when I play. Yeah, you know, that is always an option. Not the one I'd like to go with. I kind of have this thing about not cheating beyond just the mods that I use. But yeah, definitely an option. E. So eventually we will turn this into an actual blaze farm down the road. Not at the moment, but down the road. All right, I'm just going to take some of this glowstone because I do like to have it. I lost the thingy, so let's just put that back there. Okay, so now no withers can get in here with me. So that's a safe spot. Let's just torch that. Why not? And put this back here. Okay. Now, and Ryan, let's see. If you make a backup netherite sword with sharpness, could you name it the Great Lionel Blade? All right, so netherite sword with sharpness. And we're going to name it the Great Lionel Blade. Okay, so hot pink sticky note makes it official. We will probably do that in the hardcore world, Ryan, actually, because I already have a bunch of swords. And it'll be easier to upgrade than to wait till we get one in this level. This game, I should say. I apologize. I know what I was trying to say. All right, so let's see if we can get some blaze rods. That will achieve the rest of our needs here. Okay, you guys gonna come down? Come on. Come on over. Ooh. Don't light me on fire. That's rude. All right, we do have the bow and arrow. Let's see. Nope. I gotta get up just a little bit. Okay, there's one. I'm trying to aggro them to come down here at me. It's really hard to, like, fire through these pixels. Nope, I'm not hitting it. Dang it. Okay. Mom, I actually owe my followers a stream, so I'm going to head off and do that before I forget. Well, Ferrito, you do what you gotta do, my man. Just a reminder, never a good play to, self-promote in someone else's stream. But I do hope you have a good time on yours. Okay, come on. I need you guys to come down here. Come on. Come on. Okay, we might have to do it this way. We might have to do this. Get a little bit up underneath them here, like so. Oh, there we go. There we go. And we do have that looting. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, I got to do the thing. There we go. There we go. Okay. So, that's what we're doing right there. We'll set up something maybe with like a hopper system and some chests. Because this is just a very, very rudimentary little blaze farm. But at the moment, we're good with what we got here. I am going to do this. Because we want them to come down, we want them to aggro, but we don't want them to be able to get to me. So I do this, and it gets them to come down. They can see me here. Come on. I know you know I'm here. Come on. Come on over. You can do it. Come on. There you go. Come on. Come get me. Come on. You know you wanna. I need to use my looting sword so that way I can get the stuff. Anyway, trying to get them to come down is kind of the pain in the butt, honestly. Not gonna lie. Nope. As they try to light me on fire. It's fine. Come on, guys. Come on. Come on, drop down. Drop down. You can do it. I know you're right there. Come on. Come on. Drop down for me. Come on. Oh, dang it. Oh, and he's got blaze rods. I can't get to him. Nuts. Okay, you know what? I'm on fire. I'm on fire. I'm on fire. It's fine. Everything's fine. We're good. No concerns. No worries. We got this. Okay, there's my blaze rods right up there. I can't get to them. We have to get them to drop down here. Oh, there's some. Can't get to them, but they're there. Quick dive in. Quick dive in. Quick dive in. We go behind. We go behind. I eat. It's fine. Everything's fine. New block. New block. Okay. Phew. That way they can't come through. Come on. Oh, there's a whole bunch of them. Oh, crap. It's fine. Everything's fine. Come on. Get down here. I only have 5. I need more. I need more. I want to have like 20. That way I have enough for potions and I have enough for all the stuff. Come on. Come on. Get down here. Okay. You know what? We're going to have to do the thing. We're going to have to do the thing. I know they're, like, right there. Aha, I hit your feet. Take that. I got your feeties. Come on. Come down here. Come get me. Oh, there's one. Oh, blaze rod. Blaze rod. Gimme. Ah! It's fine. Everything's fine. I'm not freaking out. Shut up. Quit shooting me.
Quit shooting me.
Rude. Oh, no. The melee. Yes. Where's my blaze rods? Ah! Stop it.
Quit lighting me on fire.
Okay. This is not cool. Quit it. Ooh, blaze rod. I need to get over there. Okay, we're gonna break it. We're gonna dive in. We're gonna dive out. Because I know there's another one right there. Don't shoot me. Don't you shoot me. And don't you burn up my blaze rod. Nope, stop it. My blaze rod. Nope. Mine. Die, you evil beast. And give me your blaze rods. Gimme. Stop it. I know there's more up there. I know they are. Oh crap. Okay, we got a piglin up here. I gotta be careful. I don't know where he is, but I gotta be careful. I do not need them all aggroing on me. I want those two blaze rods there, but I can't get to them. We are fire. Yeah, oh, nope. We're gonna change. Because I want looting. Because I want that right there. Okay, here we go. We're gonna dive in and dive out. I got fire res. It's fine. I got fire res. We're good. I'm on fire, but it's okay. We're okay. Because we fixed the... Oh, there's more. There's more right there. It's okay to have the fire temporarily because the fire res protect. It's fine. Okay, more blaze rod. All right, so we're going to put this block back here. We're going to break... Right, hold on, I got to eat first. Eat. That life, being on fire and going, this is fine. It's all fine. Everything's fine. All right. Okay. Blaze rod. Sword out. Oh, there's more up there. Crap, I want them all. I'm about ready to use this notch apple just that way I can, like, just go full on, like, give me the stuff. Oh, and there's so many blaze rods and I can't get to any of them. Dang it. No, okay. Hold on. Block. It's fine. Everything's fine. Come on. Give me the blaze rods. Ah! Oh, I'm on fire. Like, full on fire. I'm on fire. Okay. All right. We're good. Okay. Give me this. Okay. There's another one here. Kill you. Oh, there's more. Okay. I want my blaze rods, though, but there's more. Okay. You know what? Forget it. Bob and weave. Oh, they burned up the blaze rods. You rat bastards. That's my blaze rods. No. All right, what do we got? We got 25. All right, I feel like I need to get some more. Yeah, we got to get those rods. That's right. Oh, there's more up there. Gosh darn it. Okay, you know what? Hold up. This may be the death of me right here, but I'm going to do it. Here we go. Okay. Quickly block back so they can't squeak through, I hope. It's fine. There we go. Okay, I got those two. That's fine. There's another guy up there. We're going to get him. Come on. Come down here. Come on. I'm going to swipe the ankles. Let's go. Come on. Get down here. Ah! Come down here. No, stop it. All right, there's another one. I'm going to get that. Eat. Boop him as I come through. Oh, I got to eat. We need carrots. We got carrots. Okay, carrots are good. No. Get back. Back, you evil beast! No! Oh my God! No! Oh. Sorry for the screaming. By the way, I apologize for the screaming. Headphone wearers, I'm terribly sorry. It's fine. Everything's fine. Ah, quit it. Okay, you need to give me blaze rods. Thank you. Okay, nope. Don't you hit me. Come on. Drop down. Okay, that's 32. That's we're doing good. No, you didn't. Nope. Okay, there's those two. Okay, let's see if I can get... Okay, there's two right there. I literally want to run in. We're just going to run in. We're going to grab. And we're going to replace. Oh, yeah, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, last one, and then we're done. We're out. As soon as I kill this guy, we're done. Because there's 40 right there, and I don't want to waste any more. Oh, hold on. We've got a Wither Skelly out here. Where are we going to get home? I don't remember. Where is he? He's over there. Okay, we gotta go this way to go home. We're done. You should, like, start with the last one. I know, right? Just last one. Last one, I swear. No more. No, I really am. I'm going to go because I've got 40. I don't want to waste them. We're going to go home. We're going to drop all this stuff off. This was a good expedition. Woo! I think that's a good spot to call break time once I get back to the house with all of our lootage here. Let's see. What do we got? We have lots of stuff here we're gonna grab. So let's see real quick. Let's just offload all of the non-essential things to start. Woo! I'm a little bit shaky, but like good shaky. That was awesome. There is something to be said for not having to worry about dying. Like, if you die, that sucks, but okay, whatever, we come back from that. The stars sound like you. Could be either way. Who's to say? All right. A lot of this stuff, we'll take all this because we're just going to smelt all that down anyway. Actually, you know, the saddles, I don't need as much of. The chests, I'll take. A lot of this stuff we'll come back and get on our next trip. That stuff is not nearly as essential. This is going to stay. I need some blocks just in case. All right, so to get home, how do we get home? We go this way. I think Mom and I are kindred spirits with that one. Yeah, no, absolutely. Star and I definitely are. I feel like they channel each other. We do, yes, absolutely. I think definitely it explains a lot in terms of our friendship and then, you know, just why she and I work really well together. We both have a very similar creative nature and personality-wise are very similar. So yeah, we just jive. All right, so we gotta go up and then across our little bridge there. Just kind of keeping half an eye on the mini-map so that way we don't get any baddies sneaking up behind us, although the worst of them are back at the fortress, so that's fine. All right, down we go. Down this way, following the torches back out. They're not all on the right, but at least it is the only torch path that I have to be on. And we should get back to our little hub spot over here pretty quickly. Oof, this is a hot mess. We need to clean that up. And armor's fully charged. Nice. Okay, now where do we go? This way? Yes, okay, there's torch. Here we go. And staircase down. This, I think, goes back. Does this go back to our hub? Hold on, which way is to our hub? Oh, that's out. That is out. I remember that went out. So we don't even want to go that way. Levi, good morning to you. Hope you're doing well. You've gone live an hour early. What? What? No, 9 o'clock. That's what it says on the schedule. All right, it's 3:37 a.m., which means when we walk out of this portal, there are going to be monsters. I can almost guarantee it. Somewhere here, there's gonna be mobs. I don't know where. Actually, they're all over on the other island, so we're fine. We sleep, everybody. We made it home. First trip to the Nether, well, not first trip. First trip to the Nether Fortress is a win. We got all the materials we got and did not die, which is shocking. All right, so we have slept. We've reset our spawn point. Let's take a pause right here for everybody to go ahead and use the restroom, refill your cups. Yes, my cups, every cup, every day a new cup because I have a boatload of them. I have this weird thing about reusing my cups day after day after day, even though it's just water, because I know about bacterial multiplication and stuff. So no, new cup every day. But anyway, so let's take a few minutes break, stretch your legs, use the restroom, grab a snack, whatever you guys need to do. And when we come back, we're gonna put all this stuff away and probably, what do we wanna do? Drop me a note in the chat about what we wanna do. We could start looking for the stronghold if you guys are interested. Maybe go out and do a little exploring, look for the stronghold? Question mark? Let me know in the chat. Catch you guys in just a few minutes. Alrighty, my friends. Welcome back. Hope you guys all had a good break. I'm just catching up on the chat here. Okay, so we're talking about Hasbin Hotel. Do some building. Let's see here. Okay, so we're all for the building. Okay, I'm down for that. If you guys want to do building, I am down for that 100%. Let me go ahead and offload all of our loot that we collected here. We have armor trim somewhere. Right there, armor trims. We have rib, dune, and a whole bunch of coast because we keep finding ruins, which is fine. Potion brewing supplies. Yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. We will need to make a nether wart farm, and we need to work on getting some ender pearls because I don't have any yet. Clerics. We do have a cleric, though. We need to work on moving our cleric over by the librarians, I think. And then we can get him set up there. In fact, let me see. I do have brewing stands, so we can get him set up over there and work on doing some trades. We have a whole bunch of armor and junk that we're just gonna drop right in here because we don't need any of that. Make sure we have some coal in there. Yes, we do. Oh, apparently we had some gold in there. I didn't realize it. I love the boots I'm wearing, but the only downside is they somehow make my feet cold despite socks. I don't know, what material are the boots? I'm assuming leather. Okay, diamonds. Hey, more diamonds. Almost a full stack of diamonds. Yeah. Hey, we got a little more glowstone. We've got some iron and some gold. Iron's always good. Speaking of which, we need to go grab whatever iron we have and put that in there. Gold and gold. We have a good bit of gold ore. We have lots of nuggies from doing random things. Here are cookies for all of our lurkers. Thank you, Levi. I appreciate that. And also thank you for the lurk message. Okay, bones away. And we're going to work on moving our cleric. I have desperately got to recharge my tools because they are bad. Let me see here. Real quick, before we go any further, we're going to grab our stuff back. Because we're back in the overworld now. So let's put all of our stuff here. Let's put away our nether stuff, which is basically just our gold boots. There are leather metal toe plates, though, and they usually don't have... Oh, yeah, I'm sure the metal toe plate probably is not helping matters at all. We've got our bed. We've got our little thing there. We are missing a crafting table, so we do need to grab one of those. And we also need a little bit more wood because we're getting a little bit low on our torch materials. Do we have any sticks? Oh, we do have sticks. Nice. Okay, so we've got sticks. We need some coal. I always like to, like, recharge things. Exclamation mark craft. Oh, that's not a thing. What are you trying to do there, Ryan? What's the command you thought you were doing? Because it might be one I can add. I'm always down for new commands. Those are fun. All right, so there we go. Everybody's happy in the inventory again. We just need our crafting table, which we might have. No, we do not have a crafting table. Sag. That's okay. We have a bunch here, though. Let's do this. Make a quick one. Because it's always good to have. Let's see, do we have any emeralds already stashed away? We have none. All right, that's going to make things a little harder. It's a stream element thing from Starship. Yeah, no, I understand. But what were you, like, what is the goal of that command? Like, what does it do on stream? That's what I'm asking. All right, we got a little rail, or a little minecart. That's the thing I'm looking for. Because we have two. We have a cleric here, we have a stonemason here that needs to go. And we need this stuff here. I don't know. I don't know if I'm set up across the river, though. That is one thing I need to check on. I need to make sure that, that I have that ready to move villagers the way I want them to move. No, I need you to not do that. Thank you. We're going to move our cleric first. So let's go across the river real quick. And we're going to make sure it's ready to move him to the library. Oh, it pops up a sticker in the middle of the screen and plays a sound effect. Oh, okay. Yeah, no, I don't have any stickers on my stream. I find them a little distracting with the ADHD, if I could word, it is kind of an issue. So, yeah, while I have some fun stuff, I don't have a ton, only because it can be a little overwhelming for me as a streamer. Yeah. Ooh, shiny. Yeah, we do have that as an audio, though. Okay, so we have all of our librarians. I think we're going to take our cleric and we're going to move him right over here by our cartographer. So let's get rid of that. We can do a few more of these. 1, 2, 3, and then we'll go with this. Powered rail. And that's fine. Torch. We have to make sure the torches are on the same side, because OCD. Just a little bit. Let's see. This one, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I think we'll do... Actually, no, I'm going to pop out and do a powered rail right here, just because I don't want to, like, yeet the guy through the wall. That won't be good. I do also need to put a block behind wherever he's going to go. So we've got okay, so it goes to the left. So he's actually going to go here. And so, we got to move it back a little bit. And honestly, he might make it. It might actually work. New. Wrong way. Thank you. He's got to go right there. So this is going to come up here. We got to remove the stair. This is different. This is job, lever, flat, and then design. This is job, lever, straight down. Oh, we have a difference here I didn't realize. Oh, so we need to actually add a whole other little pathway there. Oh, that's good to know. Alrighty. It's fine. We can make it work. I just didn't realize it was like that. This whole time, never noticed the difference. Oh, well, that's okay. All right, there we go. So that's where our first cleric is going to go. And we're going to yeet him over here in a second and get him set up with his spot. We need trapdoors, which I don't think I have any here. No, we have no trapdoors. So we need trapdoors. And we need to get some means of trade. What do clerics buy? Clerics buy rotten flesh. They buy nether wart, but I don't have enough to sell yet, so we have to wait till we farm that. And then we can sell some of that. I want to say they buy glass bottles, but I could be wrong. What do we have in the way of rotten flesh? Let me see. Absolutely none. Okay. Never mind there. We're not going to do that. All right, let's go back here real quick. Egg check. Egg. Much egg. Okay, so we'll have to start moving those eggs out elsewhere. But not today. That is a job for future me. All right. You, my friend, are moving to your new home. So I'm going to just give you a little boop and a push, and I'll meet you on the other side. And I will follow you along the river until we get to your spot. After having killed Carl with a move gone wrong, I always like to make sure I'm heading the right way. Like, or heading the same way as them immediately after, so I can rescue them if they get suffocated into a block. Because rip Carl. It was very sad. Very traumatic to watch. All right, my friend. And we can leave that. We're going to pop that down, pop it back up, take that, and then we're going to... I forgot the freaking trapdoors. Dang it. Okay, so he will he'll buy gold. He'll buy rabbit's foot, rotten flesh, scutes, which I have none of, and he'll buy glass bottles. Okay. But I need 9 glass bottles to get 1 emerald. That's not really cost efficient, quite frankly. Okay, so we need 2 trapdoors, because he needs a trapdoor and the cleric needs a trapdoor. And frankly, we just need to bring a whole bunch of trapdoors over here. So I think we're going to do that. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. All right, so that guy has moved, which is good. I've been needing to move him for a while. Ow, break my ankles. And I just haven't done it, and I've been needing to for a while. So... that is done. So let me see. I'm trying to think what I want to build. We do need to build the nether wart farm because we have to get that done. We also need to finish moving the mountain, like getting rid of the mountain, and building our melon farm. So maybe we'll work on both those things if we have time. Why did I come in here? Trapdoors. There's the ADHD doing its thing. We're good. All right, so we'll run across. We'll tuck in our 2 little villagers that don't have doors. Nicholas just spun around so fast and kind of freaked me out. I was like, what? What are you looking at? What's wrong? Chill, my dude. Whenever a golem suddenly spins around and it looks like they're, like, aggroed on me, I always get a little bit clenched up. I'm not gonna lie. I'm like, argh! We're good. Chill. Alrighty. So here we go. Do-do-do-do-do. Alright, now you are safe. We must put this right here on top of that. And then we close. Ta-da! Mad golem, scary golem. Yeah, seriously, especially because they will destroy me in like 1 hit. There, now you're safe. Trust me, Mom, I get you. My ADHD is bad today. Yeah, there are some days. At least they calm down eventually. Yeah, eventually. The trick, if you guys don't know, the trick to calm me down iron golems is to trade with the villagers. So if you can somehow get yourself in a position to trade with the villagers and increase the overall happiness of the community, then the golems will no longer aggro onto you. That is a safe and easy way to do that. All right, let me see here. Do we have anything else to do? So we have this one diamond pick that's like almost dead. It has two durability left on it. We need to enchant that. And it wouldn't hurt, I'm thinking, to have an extra silk touch pick. So maybe we'll do that rather than fortune. Maybe we'll just take that fortune book and go put it away. We can do mending, we can do unbreaking. We can do many things. We don't have any XP right now, but that's okay. Yeah, ADHD, go burr, 100%. So that'll be something we do with that pick later. For now, we have no extra swords in here. So definitely we'll probably do that thing, Ryan, like we talked about on the Hardcore World on Sunday. Which reminds me, for all of you who are fans of the Hardcore World, it's coming back. We're gonna start doing the Hardcore World every Sunday now, because people were down for that. So that's what we're gonna do. It should be a lot of fun. What do we got? Thorn, Silk Touch, Blast Protection, Protection. Okay, that's all armor stuff. So we got Silk Touch and Mending. We just need Unbreaking 3, which we don't have. I will probably try to enchant that pick, like, once I get the XP. I will run an enchantment, and then we'll just add stuff to it. Because there's Efficiency 5, Mending. All we need is Unbreaking, but we will enchant first, for sure. All right, let's go put our rail supplies away. We don't need those for anything except for moving villagers. So we'll put all that in here. So rails, extra mine cart. Oh, that was the junky shovel. I meant to put that in the other chest. That is our money pick. That stays with us. Blocks for who need it. Look, I'm carrying around so much stuff, and I really don't like how cluttered up my inventory is getting. It's terrible. All right, so Nether wart farm's gonna be the easiest. We'll start with that. Oh, I wish I'd brought all that nether fence back with me. Shoot, that would have been pretty awesome. We could smelt it. That would be an easy way to get more nether brick, as if we smelt the netherrack and we do it that way. Because we have a fair bit. Ooh, that doesn't go in there. Whoops. Rail supplies. Nice. Not family friendly, horse. Save that for the Mom After Dark stream. All right. That's going to get enchanted later. Where is the netherrack? Netherrack is here. We're going to do a whole bunch because we'll end up framing out our little thing. Do I have the furnace in the floor. It's behind this one though. Can I jump? Yes, I can jump. Okay, regular furnace right there. And that's blast furnace. Do I have this attached to a regular furnace? Here I am thinking, I'm being smart. You have blocks from a hot land drink. Okay, good idea, Ryan. Thank you. I didn't say anything wrong. I repeated your words. That's fair. That is fair. You did. So I'm going to finish smelting these things down, and then I'm going to move this hopper and chest back one, because this is supposed to be on a blast furnace. I thought it was, but this is on a regular furnace. So that would explain why things are going so slow when I smelt through. I thought it was kind of odd, but I thought, oh, maybe it's just my imagination. No, I was doing it wrong. So we are going to take these nuggies as soon as it's done. I think that's the last thing. Yeah, so we're going to take that. We'll break this, move it back one, and then we'll just put a stack of netherrack into this. So that way it's good to go. Actually, you know what? No, we're not. There we go, 16. So we're going to do this, and then we're going to drop these in here. I know they're not going to filter through except into the hopper, but then that way they're there, and we're good. When I come back to grab more, then they'll be ready to go. All right, iron nuggy here, and iron or gold nuggy there. Okay. Not the words, the context. Yes, context is everything. So we had our potion supplies are here, so we need these guys right now so we can get the farm going. And we're gonna find an area to do this farm. I would like to do it here, then it's all tucked away. We're gonna be doing an auto sorter. I think I will probably filter these two hoppers inward, kind of down below this or near this glowstone, and then we'll do like an auto sorter system over here somehow. I'm not sure, but like right up here will be an auto sorter for all these different crops, because we've got carrots and potatoes, and we have potatoes and beets over here. Because right now we have three farms, and in between each of the three farms is a villager where they're in a standing over a hopper minecart, and No, just a hopper. They're standing over a hopper, and it drops through. So yeah, I think we'll probably make the sorter there, so then we could do our farm right here. Beautiful. Let's stand right underneath this to center it up. Boop. I can dig right down because I know it's safe. So how many do we have? We have 64, but we only have 40 soul sand. So let's see. So there's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. So there's 25 right there. And if we go just 1, 2, 3 more rows out, that should give us, I think that's 40 if I can math right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, okay, so this should give us the full 40. FYI, if you didn't know, you can use a Fortune 3 hoe to harvest this stuff, and it does harvest quicker. Perfect, okay. Let's pop you guys here. Not quicker, sorry. You get a greater yield if you harvest with a Fortune 3 pick. Ho. Oh my god, words. I can't word. The words have gone. I'm sorry, my brain. Rip my brain. Wow, that grew fast. Holy cow. Alrighty, so we need a chest to put there. And we're going to frame this all out. Brain has become potatoes. Yes, potatoes. We likes the potatoes. I think I'm going to frame this with nether brick. And then we'll get the nether brick fence to put all the way around, and then we'll just put kind of a rail up in the front. Another gate. Gate up in the front. Seriously, words. Can't do it. Okay, we'll harvest all this melon because it needs it. The sugarcane is doing its thing. Our beautiful little sugarcane farm. So cute. I love it. Yes, potato yummy. We likes the potatoes. There is a zombie right over here, and I really want to get it and take it up to my farm, because then we get way more iron, and that would be amazing. But I'm not prepared for that yet, because you have to have like a whole little dirt tunnel leading to where you're going, so they don't burn up. Although if you get a dum-dum who won't pick up a block or something, then it's only fair game, honestly, at that point. You're too dumb to pick up a block and stay forever? Well, I guess you're out of luck. All right, grass blocks away. Pumpkin and melon away. Okay. We do need a chest to put over at the farm. Oh, we only have 2. Ooh, that's good to know. We are almost out of chests. Okay. Put that over here. I can move, I swear. So we've got an odd number. So I think what we'll do, because this is going to be our entry gate, we're going to go 1, 2, and then we'll put another 1, 2 over here when the time comes. But for right now, there's our nether wart. We're going to frame it all up. We'll put maybe some lanterns on the corners. That would be kind of cool. I think that would look nice. What am I looking for? Lanterns. So 1, 2, 3, 4. That'll be our corners there. That'll light up underneath. Let's go check on this and see how we're doing. 26. Okay, I'm going to wait for one more so I can make another block. This is just going to take like forever to do anything worthwhile here. I mean, honestly. You're back-ish. Well, welcome back-ish. Glad to see you again, my friend. Still on the phone, though, what we're doing. So I am just working on a very basic little nether wart farm, because we need the nether wart. Oh, wait, I did brick wall. Oh, wait, how do we make the fence? Oh, I have never crafted that before. Well, now that we've done it, this is what we're going to do, but good to know. whoops. I thought that's what I was making, but no, it's not. Just kidding. Oh, I should have done this first. That's okay. So this is going to go here, and then we're going to put wall around it like this, all the way around. We're going to put lanterns on the corners like this. It will look very nice. We'll put just a regular gate going through here, and yeah, that'll be this project done when the time comes. Are they fully grown already? No, they're like halfway. This guy's fully grown. So let's go ahead and harvest you. Boop. And with that, we got 3 from that one plant. So yeah, definitely go with Fortune 3, guys. I can word, but words are hard. It's fine. Okay, let's go check our iron supply real quick. The death is occurring even as we speak. Thank you. Yeah, potato brain is real. Absolutely. Okay. I kind of want to stay up and get a mob up there. So let's go ahead. We've got a couple of... actually, no, I don't want to give them fancy shovels. They'll get junky shovels. All right, so we're going to do that. We're going to try to get a zombie up to our iron farm, I think, while we wait for that stuff to smelt. So I need this here. And I'm going to do a boat just in case stuff goes sideways. I can throw them in a boat. Join the club. Bring your own butter. Yeah. You have to bring your own butter, sprinkle of chives, whatever you want to do. Real quick, guys, while I wait for the time to wind down, I'm just going to adjust our stream info if it'll let me. I think we can do that. Let's see. We're going to be trapping zombies and building stuff. That pretty much sums up what we're doing for the rest of the stream here. Is it bad that I really want fried chicken? When don't you want fried chicken? I know, right? Isn't that kind of a thing all the time? Okay, so no sleeps till Brooklyn. So we're going to try and get the zombie. So basically what the plan is we are going to sit out here until the zombies show up. And then as soon as they arrive, we are going to try to wrangle them into our farm. I already have the place ready to rock and roll where they can just drop right in. No problem. I just need them to show up. And we're going to make it a little more spawnable over here by getting rid of all these extra torches. And doing a little bit of the terraforming I needed to do anyway. So I'm going to be a little focused on this just for a minute, so that way I don't miss something spawning right next to me, because that would be really bad. I have to remind myself, don't kill the monster when it spawns. You need it. That's a song from the past. Yeah, I know, right? No! Sleep! Till Brooklyn! Love the Beastie Boys. I spent a lot of time in my teen years listening to the Beastie Boys. It was a very angsty time, but very awesome all the same. Okay. Monsters, where are you? Where are you, monsters? Okay, there's a creeper inside the cave. I don't care about him. He can just chill and do his thing. That's fine. I'm gonna continue to just terraform here. Okay, I see a zombie up there on the hill. I could run up and get him if I wanted to. I'm actually kind of surprised they spawned way the heck up there. That's kind of odd. And I have to be very careful I don't drop the wrong thing. Zombie! Zombie! Hey, zombie, come here. Come here. Follow me. Follow me right down the hill. Yeah, look, I'm gonna leave you a present right there. Come pick this present up, okay? Get this present and then follow me. Get the shovel. Get the shovel. Pick up the shovel. Pick up the shovel. Yes! We have a shovel acquirement. Kill it with fire. No, we need zombie. Zombie, come on. You're gonna follow me up these stairs, okay? Come on. Don't mind the kitty cat. Kitty's chill. Kitty's just sitting and vibing. It's fine. Zombie, where are you? Zombie? Zombie? Oh, there you are. Come here. You're going to come up the ladder. Or up the stairs, I should say. Come up the stairs. Come on. Up the stairs. Did you get confused? Come up the stairs. Up the stairs. Okay, good boy. Good boy. Come on. You're going to come around this way. You're going to come right through here. Come on. Come right through here. Right through. Right through. Oh, look at all those nice villagers. Aren't they lovely? We're going to break our ankles. Holy crap on a cracker. First try, ladies and gentlemen. And he picked up the shovel. Yes! Take that, suckers! And now we sleep. Yay! Why does he need a shovel? That keeps him from despawning. Once he has that shovel, he is good to go. He is locked and loaded. He is ours forever. We are going to name tag him, and I'm also going to give him a little helmet. Let's see. Oh, fire protection. Perfect. Let's see if he'll do that. He is there forever and ever, because once a mob picks up a block, so like an Enderman or a zombie, they are there forever. The name tag also does it, but if you don't have a name tag, then you can do... Hey, can you pick that up? Hold on. I don't want you to boot me. Oh, yeah, cool. Okay, so there. Now he's got a helmet also. Mobs that have helmets do not, or any sort of armor that they pick up will not despawn. In this case, it will help him, help give him more protection. He won't despawn. He's protected from the sun because he has a solid block and a slab over the top of him, so he will not burn. He will stay here forever. We will name tag him because people always want to name tag our mobs. But he has a fire protection helmet on, so he should be good. He's got his sunscreen. And I'm very happy that worked out so nicely. Okay, this guy over here, let's see if we can hit him from here. Let me see. Oh, first shot! We are on fire, people! Not really, because that would be bad. Ryan did want to name something. That's true. Ryan did want to name something. You are absolutely correct. Okay, now he's in the water. I don't think I'm going to be able to get him in the water, but that's okay. Nah, it's harder. Okay, you need to go chase the villagers. So, I don't know if you guys can see. There is a glass wall all the way around the villagers that there's a one block gap. Mob heads don't have durability unlike helmets. Yeah, exactly. That was a good shot. I'm very excited about that. So basically right here, what I need to do is I need to go get some more glass and block this area off so that way the zombie doesn't see me. He'll just keep walking around and chasing villagers. Because there is a one block gap through here so he can make eye contact with villagers and the villagers can make eye contact with him. So it freaks them out. As you can see, as long as they can see him, they start freaking out. These guys, because they're standing on the bed, they can't see him. That's one thing I need to kind of take into consideration is if they're standing on beds, they can't see them. I might get rid of some of their beds and just put a row like right down the middle. Or maybe I'll just get rid of the beds. I don't know. See, there's a bunch in there. So we'll see. Maybe I'll minimize. I only need 5. So I don't know. We'll figure that out. Either way, job accomplished. Yay me. Happy dance. Don't they need to break the line of sight occasionally? Yeah, so from what I understand, it helps them like rest for a minute to where they're not constantly freaking out. But can I get you in the water? Sucker. But I don't think it's like essential. Like, I think it's nice if they can break line of sight once in a while, but it's not necessary. Yeah, so I'm gonna get glass. I'm gonna block off that wall so that way he can't see me, because I don't want him to see me. Although, do I need a glass wall? I think we could just put like the brick fence and then just put a second gate so that way he can't see me. I might need to get in there at some point, like to do his, oh wait, no, hold on. If I want to do the name tag, it'll be easier if I have just a single gate initially because I can reach over. Second gate's going to be a pain because I can't reach through it. So yeah, we're just going to leave it right now. It's fine. Why do I have, why is there a block there? I see a thing. Why do I have a thing here? What is this? It's over here somewhere. Was there a mob? Well, that just scared the crap out of me. It just popped up right in front of me. I see. Anyway, I don't know if you guys can see it on the map. I have a red dot, which means there's a block that's been dropped somewhere, but I don't know what it was. Oh, something landed on my seeds. That's not cool. We need to fix that. Fix this. Plant this. Okay, there we go. Now we're good. That was no bueno. I am not a fan. So, zombie is now doing zombie things. We are getting exponentially more iron now than we were originally. We'll do a little bit more terraforming up here after I eat because hunger. And then we'll, if we have time, we'll start working on prepping for the melon farm. If we don't, well then, next time. Which will be Tuesday. Because again, just a reminder, Sunday we are going back to the hardcore world. We're going to start doing that one day a week. I really want to go explore the 1.20 chunks. I think that would be a lot of fun in the hardcore world since we have all the means to get around really easily. I want to start collecting some things we haven't collected. Like, we don't have Allays yet in the hardcore world. We haven't gotten sniffer eggs yet, which I would really like to get, like, some water breathing potions and go down into some of those drowned cities and get stuff. I do have to be careful though, because I've been playing on Star's server, and on her server, there is a lot more fun enchants that keep me safe when I do things, and I have to remember I'm not on there anymore. And I will die if I stay under the water too long and if a trident zombie hits me. I don't want to lose the hardcore world because I forgot. That would be bad. And yes, we likes the safe enchants. Those are very nice. Let me see here. I'm just going to literally just get rid of all these blocks here. All this is going to be open. This is going to be like a big ravine type thing here. I can't reach it. Dang it. Okay, we'll hop down right here. Yeah, I want to get rid of that. That we're going to get rid of. All right, this whole thing is gonna go. We're just gonna do all the things. No level 10 enchants. Yeah, no, what the heck? I'm over here roughing it with just regular old, like, Unbreaking 3 and stuff. Sucks. Like, they file a complaint with the authorities. All right, let's go drop all this extra junk off. My inventory is a hot mess, as you can see. That has to go. We're gonna go check our nether rack that's smelting, see if we've got enough to make some more fences, or sorry, walls. And then we'll get that farm finished. We have lots of grass blocks. Let's put all of you guys up here. Thank you. We have some seeds to go into the seed chest. Mini seeds. Boat can go back over here. That can go back over here. That goes back here. We have rotten flesh. Hey, we have a whole other piece of rotten flesh now. Yippee! I would like to build a mob farm, honestly, just so that way I can start getting some of the stuff to use for trades. It would be nice. Okay. We're good there. Oh, smelter. Smelter. Forgot that. Gotta do the smelter. What do we got? Okay. Yep, we got a whole set here. Crafting table. We're gonna make the blocks. I'm gonna go ahead and ring the farm first. I'm not gonna make any more wall until the farm is completely wrapped in the blocks. I miss them when I'm not on the server. Yeah, buddy. Having to, like, vanilla rough it sucks. Not a fan. Do not recommend. All right, so we're gonna finish with that. Put all of our lanterns on. And some of these guys are ready, but we're just gonna wait till the whole thing's done. Because why not? Do. Okay, I gotta be careful. There is a creeper over here. I see it. Actually, he's underground. I thought it was right here, but no, it's underground. What I'm gonna do right here is when we get to, actually maybe right here, we're just gonna shave this off. We're just gonna open this whole thing here. And we're gonna make this wall extend straight across. And we'll do something over here. Maybe build like a big retaining wall up along here, kind of like how we've been doing across the way over there, how we've got all of our cobble retaining wall. We might do that right here and just make this blocked off. Cause this cave over here, eventually we're gonna explore, but I would like to just have this area not exposed or not not the way it is right now. I want it to just be open, like a big ravine gully kind of thing. I think that'll look really, really cool. So we're gonna, I know the no block left behind rule, we're breaking that, but I wanna just get rid of all this right here. Just take it all down. Away with ya. I hear lava, I have to be careful that I don't dig straight into it. That would not make for a fun day. You know, we could just drop down here. I would be okay with dropping down. Because then I could pick up all these blocks. Beep. Maybe put a couple torches over here. We could do that. There are mobs here. I have to be careful. Let's not be stupid. No stupidity. Nope. There. Okay. I bet they're down in here. Actually, they're right here in front of me, so I gotta be careful. They're either in that cave or they're in the cave over there. Terrifying. Alright, that's good. Now we're gonna come right back over here. I'm gonna pillar back up. Get myself to safety. I don't know why I'm so scared. It's hard mode, and if I die, I spawn right there. I can come back and get my stuff. But there's just something about, now that I've been thinking about hardcore again, it's starting to make me antsy when I play. I don't want to die! Whereas, like, just a week ago, I'm like, eh, I died to an Enderman. It sucks, but whatever. It is what it is. I'll go back and get my stuff. It's in the hallway. It's fine. Give me that. Okay. So much freaking blocks. Alrighty. Well, while I do this tedious and monotonous stuff... Oh, there's the lava. Found it. I'd love to hear what you guys are going to be up to going into this weekend. If you've got any fun and exciting plans, now is the time to drop in the chat. Tell us all about it. I would love to hear it. It's always fun to hear what people have going on. I'm trying to think. I don't think I have a ton going on this weekend. Although I could be wrong, but I don't think so. Get rid of you and you. I'm just kind of terraforming this down into this area here, like so. There we go. All right. Where was that lava at? Oh, it's getting late. It's getting dark. We must go back. We've done the mob acquirement. We don't need any more. Man, I miss Sharp X and one-shotting almost everything. Yeah, I love the, like, knockback 3 million or whatever it is on there. Like, I could hit a mob right here and it would literally land in the water. It's so awesome. Those are like the best enchants, man. I figured out how I'm going to design the nether portal for my base. Ooh, tell us all about it. I'd love to hear it. You have some very creative builds, Levi, and I'd love to hear what you're up to. All right, let's pop this stuff back in the chest while Levi tells us his plan. I'm thinking we're going to take some of this stuff here. So we've got brick. We have a little bit of wall here. Just a Lost M. Love that name. Welcome into the chat for the first time. Glad to have you. How are you doing today? What are you up to? Anything fun and exciting? And if you don't mind sharing, how'd you find our little community? I'm always kind of curious how new folks come across us, because we're small. We're not the big folks here. All right, we got wall. Let's put the stone back away here. Okay. I'll just have to wait and see. Okay, fine, Levi, whatever. No fun, but whatever. It's really cool. All right, I trust you. I'm sure it is. Levi is very creative and has fantastic builds, so I don't doubt it at all. Alrighty, let's see. Not really, just cleaned my house. Oh, nice. Hey, productivity is good. So don't help with the lava then. Oh, there you go. That's fine, no lava for you then. All right, I'm gonna get rid of this temporarily. All right, now, mobs cannot get up here because, oh, hi. Hi, how's it going? I hate to tell you this, but I'm gonna have to kill you. So have a nice day. Peace out. Found you in recommended. Oh, cool, so we're hitting recommended again. That's pretty snazzy. It's been a minute since we were on there, but it's also been a minute since I was regularly streaming, so that probably has something to do with it. Up until recently, I was working a full-time job outside the home, and it just completely ate up any free time I had. But now I'm back in the land of the unemployed, voluntarily. And so we've been hanging out and doing the stream a lot more, which is awesome. And I'm glad to see that we are popping up on that recommended again. We always enjoy when new folks come to visit. All right, let's do some terraforming here. Boom. All right, chat, gotta get going. Got an appointment to get you. Well, horse, good luck with that appointment. I hope everything goes well. I'm sure you'll tell me all about it afterwards. Be well, and thanks for hanging out in chat today. This is a private server. This is actually a single player survival. The server I was discussing earlier, if you happen to hear it, is a Starfire. It has a private server that we happen to play on together outside of my stream. And this is just a regular single player survival. Generally I'm a hardcore player, but I was kind of taking a little break just because I got kind of burned out, and so this is just kind of my fun world. But we will be heading back to the hardcore world soon, so if that's something you're interested in, every Sunday I will be streaming from the hardcore world again, and it's a 4430 day hardcore world, so 4430 days. Yeah, Horace has been driving for a while. He's just been listening. That's why he hasn't been chatting much, is because he's driving. Because that's not safe, and we always encourage no texting and driving, even though I'm really bad about doing it, I will admit. Yeah, he's been driving for a while. I need this, because we gotta rip out all this. This is all that moss we played with the last time we were over here terraforming. Hey, there's our cave. I knew we'd be hitting eventually. So right over there is that cave we gotta watch out for. That is going to be a problem. That water cave, I'm going to be filling in. And we're going to be torching up the cave underneath so that it's spawn-proofed. Because the less spawns, the less lag. So that's what we're going to be working on as we continue with this part of the project. I do want to pick up all this moss, though. Moss is very useful for many, many different things. Not just decorations, but also bone meal and mountain eradication when you want to minimize loss to your tools. Let the moss work for you. Sounds like some weird, like, corporate slogan. Let it work for you. Okay, I just want to get it all, and then we'll go back and pick everything up. So we'll go right there, and then just swoosh all this off. Oh, okay, we got cave all over underneath here. We have to be very careful, because I almost just fell down into it. I didn't realize it was like a zigzag kind of thing. That would have been bad. No dying today, please. Not that I would. I have Feather Falling 4 on, but I still don't need to hurt myself. That would be no bueno. Okay, I think that's all the moss on this layer. Obviously, I'm gonna have to go drop some stuff off because I have too much crap in my inventory. Seeds away. I'm sure I'll pick them up later, but for right now, let's just get all the blocks. Watching out for the spawn area down there. Make sure nobody's shooting up at me, because I did have that happen earlier when that was an open cave, and I had mobs shooting up at me, which was kind of rude. I'm not gonna lie. Mini, it hits 11:30, and everything wants to call. Oh, the minute it hits, and it's 11:30. Everyone wants to call or need something. Still on the phone, but glad things are going smoothly. You know, I totally feel that. It feels like there are some days where I'm sitting around twiddling my thumbs, bored out of my mind, nothing to do. And there are days where I swear it feels like every person under the sun wants something from me, and I cannot get a moment's peace or a moment's rest physically, because I'm just going constantly. And it really waxes and wanes. That's work sometimes at the end of the day. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I've definitely been there. All right, let's get rid of that, and we're going to get rid of this stone here. And I'm also going to get rid of this right here. This I don't want anymore. Excuse me. I apologize for that. Gold carrots. Okay. We're going to continue on over here. We're going to grab some more of that dirt out. I'm going to keep pushing back to the open cave. As soon as we have a good amount of open cave, then we'll start filling in the water and everything. I just want to see where the cave is before I do that. All right. Random terraforming here. We don't want our edge here to be too perfect pyramid-y, because otherwise that looks really weird, and it looks like you're trying to build a dirt pyramid, and no one wants that, so. I'm just going to kind of swing the shovel back and forth, and wherever it lands, it lands. There we go. I am crouching this whole time because we know there's open cave, and I don't want to fall down on top of a creeper. I have this thing about personal space, and not having my personal space blown up. Thank you. I like death, but only when it's someone else, and preferably the hostile mobs, because they're kind of rude, and I don't like them. Just saying. All right. Grass block there. Let's go back and pick all these guys up. Alrighty. Ta-dum. And we got more dirt here. All right, now let's wipe all this. We're gonna have to go trade soon. We're gonna have to get some XP so we can recharge our shovel and our pick, because they're starting to get a little bit low. I like death when it's someone else. Yeah, we have this whole thing where I'm like, yay, death, because it never fails. When I'm doing things, I get very like excited when I kill a mob, and so it's always like, yay, death. But what if the creeper can help you with your car's extended warranty? I know, right? He's selling encyclopedias. I should really give him the time of day and chit-chat with him and you know, maybe make a deal. All right, I'm going to do this. I'm just going to push this back. I know mobs can climb up at me, which is probably not the best idea, but that's okay. Because we're going to be working on filling all that in a minute. So I'm just going to remove all this. There we go. Let's make it where I can get up and down in here. Okay. Hey, there we go. That looks like the play. And then we'll push this back. Alrighty, there's the cave right there. So, let's do this. I am not going to break that water just yet, because right now that's pushing back any mobs that might be there. I can start filling in over here while watching the mini-map to make sure nobody spawns near me and starts coming up the path, because there are mobs in there. You can see them on the mini-map. They're back a ways, but they are there. So, we're going to very carefully, if I can, okay, you know what? Down. We're going to do this. Make it where I can come across, come back up, because I don't want to drown. Oh, shoot. We got to get rid of all the water source blocks. So that way it doesn't, like, start flowing the minute I break something. Come on. All right. There's still a zombie over that way, but I don't care about that. He's not my problem. There's that. Okay, we're gonna peek right here. Okay, what do we got? We've got skeleton maybe down there. Maybe not. I don't know. I'm gonna drop down though, because in the water I shouldn't have any issues with them. Just trying to get where I have all of the little air pockets eliminated. And we'll worry about the rest of all this later. Hate water pools. They're always in like the worst spot. right when you're trying to do something, you get a stupid water pool. Okay, we gotta get right over here. Quickly fill in. Oh, hold on, hold on. This has to go, because there's a water pocket there. Or air pocket, I should say. Being mindful. I do have respiration 3, which gives us an extra few seconds of placement time, but I still don't want to drown. Okay, and up. I really need to get up. Yes, if you have not gotten up and going, it is time. Okay, let's do a little bit more of this. Break that moss. I'm gonna push this back in case we have any other water cave. I don't know if we do. And no, it looks like that's pretty much it. Hey, Miner Mom, welcome in. Hope you're having a great Thursday. Yeah, so we're out of the Nether. We did the scary Bernie things. I made a very crude blaze farm. Because we did find a blaze spawner that looks like it's totally enclosed, actually. It, from looking at the map, it looks like it's completely, like, within Netherrack. So I was able to get them to filter down towards me at a little spot that I created to keep myself safe. I only got lit on fire, like, a dozen times. It's fine. But I do actually have fire res on both my helmet and my boots, so that's good. Okay, we're going to start the day off with a storm. Is that a thunderstorm? No, I just have to work in the rain all day. Cool, thanks. Just what I wanted to do. But yeah, so I got 40 blaze rods and I got some nether wart and soul sand. So we got all three items that we needed to get out of the Nether. We should be good now. I got 40, right? Yeah, 40 blaze rods because I have looting 3 on my sword. So we were able to get lots of good stuff that way. We're gonna make some more of our bricks. We're gonna go place those. That's annoying, 64 netherrack just to get 16 bricks. What a pain in the butt. But yeah, so we're off to a good start. We've got everything we need to do our potion brewing. I will be making some fire res as soon as I get some magma cream. And okay, we can start doing this now. Let's do that. We're just gonna put this at the corners for now. Ugh, slow, so slow. It's fine, everything's fine. Right there and there. So you're pretty much charging off in this world then. Yeah, so basically my goal is I put out there as an option today that we could go looking for the stronghold, but chat said they wanted me to build stuff. So instead we're building. But in order to get building, I have to do some more terraforming. I have to get rid of some of this extra holes in the ground and things so we can have our melon farm kind of be on the ground right here level with this area. So we have to push all this back up against this mountain. We're also taking this area here and we're creating kind of a ravine passage type of thing. We'll have a wall across this way and then we'll have a big retaining wall, much like how we're gonna build a retaining wall right here and wrap around our farm. We're also gonna have a retaining wall around this mountain. So that way it ends up looking kind of like how our tiered city is on the other side. We want it to kind of mirror in terms of the aesthetic. It won't be exactly the same, but it'll be close. So I'm good with that. Give me 1 second. And let's do this. All right. We're gonna terraform and hopefully nothing jumps up at us from that cave. I need to get some more dirt so that way I can go in the water and finish filling that in. And we got to go into that cave and torch it up so that way we don't have mobs spawning near our base. We want minimal mob spawns near our base if possible, because monsters are the worst and I hate them, and you know, mob caps and all that good stuff. All right, we're doing this. We're pushing this back. Yep. Okay, there's creeper right there. Hi creeper, I see you. You stay down there, you're fine. I need this, thank you. Let me see. We got blocks. Okay, you know what? We're just gonna do this. If I die down here, I go right back to my bed. It's fine. All right, torch. Torch. Where'd he go? Did he get pushed down? Oh, there he is. There we go. He dead. Cool. All right, let's light this place up. That was not what I was going for. Thank you. And I gotta be careful because gravel. Nope, gravel's fine. Die right there. This water's gonna get plugged up soon enough. For right now, we're just gonna do this. I don't want to flow downstream, but I think I'm gonna. Nope, nope, nope. Okay, There's more cave over that way. I will worry about that later. Right now, I did what I needed to do here. Now we're gonna start plugging water up. This whole area is gonna get filled in with dirt, including over here, so that way I can then terraform pushing back. Magma cream, perfect for achieving that hot demonic look. That's right. That's exactly what we want to. All right, I need all this dirt because we're gonna be filling up the side of the hole there. All this and this. I should really get our kitties out of the water. That's not very nice of me to leave them sitting there. I just realized they were there. I'm a bad pet parent. Leave my kitties out in the rain. Alrighty, down we go here. We're gonna finish plugging up all this water. And we will then stop that water flow, which will of course mean that mobs will start like coming up the tunnel there, but eventually we're gonna block it over. I'm not gonna close it up completely. We're actually gonna leave a little passageway there. So if I wanna go caving it another time, I can, and I have access. I actually like having my caves open and accessible like that. It's kind of fun. And it gives me the control to make sure that mobs only spawn where I want them to, when I want them to, and they can't sneak up on me, because that's never nice. Speaking of which, now that I have that water no longer flowing, I do have to be careful because mobs can start coming up the pathway there. So there's no water pushing them back. A lot of this is going to get removed eventually, honestly, because we're going to keep pushing this hillside back. But now I don't have to worry about open spots. I just remove what I want where I want. Because again, no air pockets. In fact, let's do this. Break you, put the torch down here on the floor. We will make an access point probably right about this spot. Or actually, no, it's going to be further back. So the access might actually end up being over there. Basically, we'll put a ladder getting down in there. So that way, I can control getting up and down. Nothing else can join me without my permission. Because consent matters. And thank you, Miner Mom, for the lurk. I appreciate it. We'll hopefully see you before the end of stream. But if not, have a great rest of your day. Alrighty, so right here, oh, I probably should have filled that in too, just in case. Continuing to fill this hole. No, not you. You go away. This block stays behind. This wall here we'll make just so that we can have a clear border. I do not want to sit in this two-hour meeting. Oh, Razor, I feel that, my friend. Meetings are the worst. I had to do a lot of meetings at my old job, and oh my God, so much sitting around and being told things that could have literally just been an email. It is the worst. I'm sure at some point in my life I'll have a corporate job again, but God, I hope it's not anytime soon. Because, oh, they're the worst. Okay, so we've got a cave entrance right, or we've got the entrance over here, but I kind of want to say this is where we're going to actually do our full entrance in here, I think. Yeah, I think that'd be a good idea. Okay, so we've got a skelly who's coming up here. Oh, hi. Hi, guys. How's it going? Oh, you have a bone? Here, I'm going to help you take care of that. You just go right on down there. Oh, I missed that shot. Okay, you're dead. That's fine. But we need breaks to talk sports ball and why they can't get yachts, but we can get a good raise. Yeah, right. Oh, they can get yachts, but we can't get a good raise. Yeah, isn't that lovely how that works out? Yeah, gotta love it. That is one reason I hated my corporate job, because there was a lot of that kind of hypocrisy and things that I don't really jive with. Not a fan. All right, so we got a creeper down there too. Let's see if I can get him. Oh, creeper, can you come right back over here? Maybe just like poke a pixel out. Oh, no, I missed your feet. I'll trade your razor, want to scrub toilets. You know, honestly, I'm not going to lie. I would rather do that than deal with having to sit in meetings that are completely redundant and unnecessary. Yeah, not going to lie. If I get paid, absolutely. I am not above scrubbing toilets for work. 100%. I have always been a firm believer that a job is a job. As long as you are a contributing member of society, it doesn't matter what you do, because everybody's role is important in our world. If there was no one to scrub the toilets, then they would never get scrubbed. So, you know, if you can do that job and get paid for it, kudos. My body would do that stuff I did as a kid. I would go back to hazmat. Oh, yes. Hazmat's fun. Tovenator hates hazmat stuff. I always hear about the hazmat stuff. Not a fan. Okay, so this is right now my access point, but we're gonna do something a little bit safer and tidier here. Pretty much minimum, yeah, but you know what? A job is a job is a job, my friend. If it helps pay the bills and helps put food on the table and takes care of your family, that is all that matters. Who cares how much you get paid? I mean, obviously we all wanna get paid an extravagant sum for our troubles, but you know what? A job is a job is a job. And nothing to it. I mean, you know, be proud of your contributions to society and to your family. All right, just doing the terraforming here. We'll wrap around there. So this is looking a little bit pyramidy right here, so we might have to make some changes, but overall it's not too bad. Let's go back to the house. Let's drop off some of this extra stuff. And let me see, how much more are we gonna be able to do? We're like right at the 2-hour mark. This is kind of the point where I said mentally I was gonna stop stream. So this might be a good spot to break anyway, since we're putting things away and getting ready to sleep. So let's see, let's put the moss away. What else have we got here? Oh, we've got some copper, which we don't need in this world just yet. Eventually we will, but not yet. We got a little bit of moss, a little bit of copper. We're gonna put both those guys away here. Fare thee well. And there we go. Okay, so let's sleep. Everybody take one final drink. And right there is where we're going to close out our survival day. I had a wonderful time hanging out with you guys today. Hope you all did too. Welcome into all the new folks who have joined the community. And yes, drink very good. All the hydration. If you have someone who is streaming that you know would be a good family-friendly transition, or maybe if they're not family-friendly, but they're our kind of jam, then by all means, please drop their info in the chat and we can check them out. Let me take a peek at this person real quick. This person looks like they might be kind of our thing. We'll see. This is another mature streamer. And yes, if you are going to join us, oh, is Maymay streaming right now? And is what is Maymay playing? I do like to transition from Minecraft whenever possible, but if that's not possible, that's okay. I have a potential raid target ready to go. They are again a mature streamer in age. Oh, she is playing Minecraft. Okay. Let me just look at their info here. So it looks like they do a little bit of everything. Can you drop me Maymay's link in the chat? Anyone who has that available? And then that way I can check her stuff out real quick. Oh, it looks like this person is doing, ooh, this person that I was looking at is doing some modded Minecraft. That looks really cool. They have like magic items and things. Ooh, fancy. That's an option. All right, let me take a peek at Maymay real quick. Let's see, okay. So Maymay's content looks like they might be a little more mature. So again, if that's not your jam, no worries. They do have a follower-only chat, so that would be something to consider. So real quick poll, do we wanna go to the person who is doing the modded Minecraft, doing like magical type stuff? Or do we want to go check out Maymay stream? Which is, again, a little more mature, but still, I'm sure, a lovely, lovely stream. So you guys let me know. What do we want to do in the chat? Let me see. What is... Oh, it looks like Maymay's doing some maybe base decorating. Lots of cute stuff. All right, well, I'm gonna go ahead and make an executive decision since chat has not told me anything. So we're gonna go raid. It is quiet, I know. Crickets. So we're gonna go raid Magic Circle. So Magic Circle says that they are mature. We will go ahead and do Maymay next time. Next time Maymay's streaming, we will go ahead and we'll raid over there. I would really like to see the modded stuff. I always enjoy that. So yeah, definitely, if you guys are able to join, copy paste that raid message. We'll head over there, give this streamer a little boost, and show a little love. I've had a wonderful time today. Thank you for hanging out while I screamed my head off fighting blazes and making our fortress a little easier to traverse and somewhat safer. Maybe not 100%, but safer. I had a great time, and make sure you guys go out and do something kind today. Put a little love out in the world and help make it a better place, because goodness knows we could all use it. Have a great rest of your day, guys. I'll see you on Sunday in the hardcore world. Have a good one.